Real taste of summer, Janice. Thank you so much for that. Now I want to tell you about an event that you should really take advantage of this weekend. It was once an effort by noted artists, including the likes of Jackson Pollock, to sell artwork on the streets of New York. We're talking about the Washington Square Outdoor Art Exhibit that's returning for its 83rd year this weekend. One of the artists who will be taking part is Kevin McAvoy. He joins us now to tell us more about the exhibit. So, Kevin, thanks for coming on the show.
Very glad to be here.
And you've brought some of your work with you, which is great to see.
Yeah.
You talk about 83 years, and you know this event has to be successful because nothing unsuccessful could last this long. Tell me a little bit more about the origins.
It's pretty interesting. Jackson Pollock, you know, he couldn't pay his rent in Greenwich Village, and him and de Kooning were said to head out and just lean it up against the walls of the street. And I just found that fascinating. And I myself noted that a lot of the major artists who are exhibiting today, they actually themselves got their beginnings in the Washington Square Shell.
Yeah, it's great. And now, of course, the show has grown. There are more than 100 exhibitors.
Yeah.
And you're just a great example of where this show can take an artist. We were speaking a little bit before, and New York City can be a tough place to break into because you don't necessarily have a venue to show your work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I returned from Italy. I studied at the Charles Cecil Studios, and I had about 35 paintings, and I had nowhere to go.
Mm-hmm.
And I was knocking on doors of galleries, and they said, oh, okay, we got a lot of artists, but you know, we'll talk to you. And then the Washington Square Show it popped up. And so I brought my paintings out to the sidewalk, and within hours, I was selling them for really good prices that I was blown away by.
Yeah, no, it's great to have some kind of organized, instead of just going on the street yourself, to have some kind of organized exhibition.
Yep.
And I know we have some, I believe, pictures of your work. And so now you do commission works. Well, we don't have pictures, actually, but we do have this one. So you do commissioned portraits of folks.
I do. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's great, and now your name has spread. Tell me a little bit more, besides painting, there's other work, sculpture. Tell me a little bit more about what else we can find there.
I believe two-thirds of the show is fine art, and that ranges from, you know, photography to, in the realm of painting, abstract expressionism, abstract minimal work, and then to classical realism, such as myself.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a really, like, wide range within the fine arts, but then there's also a third of it is craft, and there's some just beautiful ceramic work and glass work and things of that sort, jewelry.
So now, in just the 5 years that you've been there, have you seen changes to the exhibition or changes in popularity even?
Well, they say there's a walkthrough of 20,000 to 30,000,
mm-hmm.
and for an artist, it's a dream come true. I found that absolutely impressive. As time went by and the market crashed and things of that sort, mm-hmm. there was, you know, a few moments there where we were all wondering what's going to happen to the show. But it just hung in there, and the sales kept coming, and the people kept coming. Because it's always been, for the buyers, it's been a great deal.
Yeah, well, because you have great quality artists, and you can get somewhat of a deal, even though I'm glad to hear that your paintings are selling for more. And you feel like you can if you go to a venue like this where there might be some undiscovered talent. So let's give folks the information. It's this Saturday and Sunday, June 1st and 2nd, from noon to 6 on University Place, between East 13th, Schwartz Plaza, and West 3rd Street. So I hope you have a lot of folks walking by.
It's free.
So check out Kevin. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with more News 4 at 7. Stay with us.